Hello students, I hope that in this lockdown period you are focusing in your studies and learning well. Today I came up with my lecture of the poem A Roadside Stance, literary devices, or you can say poetic devices, and also the keywords. This is the last part of this poem. So let's start. So first, figure of speech or literary device I'll be discussing is the personification, which is present in the poem. The examples are, first example of personification is the sadness that lurks behind the windows. The line, the sadness that lurks behind the windows, is the example of first personification. The sadness is personified, okay, and used in the poem as a kind of personification. Second one is a roadside stand that too pathetically pled. So roadside stand has been personified, is a second example of personification. Next we come to the another figure of speech in the poem, that is the alliteration. As we can see, the first example of alliteration present in the poem is greedy good doers. There is G in greedy, and also there is G present in good. So greedy good doers is an example of an alliteration. Next one is the beneficent beast of prey. So here B is common in beneficent and beast, okay. And third one which appears in the text itself is the pathetically pled. Again here similarly P is common in pathetically, and P is also common in pled. Next we come to another figure of speech used in this poem. It is the transferred epithet. So what is the meaning of a transferred epithet? It is a figure of speech in which a modifier qualifies a noun other than the person or thing it is actually describing. So usually the modifier is an adjective. So I'll be giving you the examples so that you can be clear, get cleared, okay. So I will be giving you the example of transferred epithet present in the poem itself. So they are the polished traffic. First one is the polished traffic, and other one is the selfish cars, okay. So here you can see the polished traffic. The traffic is, as a traffic is referred to as polished, but actually the traffic is not polished, but the people are polished, okay. So jis cheez ko reference diya gaya hai wo cheez ko direct nahi diya gaya hai reference, usko indirect reference diya gaya hai. Yahan pe people ko polished bataya gaya hai, lekin directly people ko polished nahi batake पोएट क्या करते हैं, ट्रैफिक को पॉलिश बताते हैं, एंड दैट इज अ एग्जांपल ऑफ अ ट्रांसफर एपिथेट. ओके, सो द लाइन फॉलोस लाइक दिस. सो क्वालिफाइज अ नाउन अदर दैन इन विच अ मॉडिफायर द पर्सन थिंग इज एक्चुअली डिस्क्राइबिंग. जो चीज को हम लोग एक्चुअल में डिस्क्राइब करते हैं उस चीज को हम लोग डायरेक्ट हम लोग रेफरेंस नहीं देके किसी और चीज़ को हम लोग रेफरेंस देते हैं, सो दैट वो डायरेक्ट चीज़ को समझाया जा सके किसी और चीज़ के माध्यम से. एंड दिस इज़ अ ट्रू एग्जांपल ऑफ अ ट्रांसपोर्ट एफिथेट. सिमिलरली व्हेन इन सेल्फिश कार्स, ओके, सो द कार्स आर नॉट सेल्फिश, द ओनर्स ऑफ द कार्स आर सेल्फिश, ओके, द पीपल हु आर सिटिंग इनसाइड द कार आर सेल्फिश, ओके, कार्स कैन नॉट बी सेल्फिश, ओके. So this is a true example of a transferred epithet. So next we find another poetic devices present in the poem, that is the metaphor. Okay, the example, as you can see, first one is the flower of cities from sinking and withering faint. It's a first example of a metaphor present in the poem. Second one, swarm over their lives. And third, teaching them to sleep, they sleep all day. There are the three metaphors present in the poem. Okay, so by this we come to the end of the poetic devices. So total there are 3 to 4 devices, poetic devices or literary devices present in the poem. First one is the personification, second one alliteration, third one is the transferred epithet, and the fourth one is the metaphor. Personification means when a non-living object is defined as a living object, referred to as a living object. Means क्या होता है, एक नॉन लिविंग ऑब्जेक्ट को हम लोग इस तरीके से ट्रीट करते हैं एज इफ इट इज़ एन लिविंग ऑब्जेक्ट. यहाँ पे तो द एग्जाम्पल वॉज गिवन, रोड साइड स्टैंड वॉज पर्सोनिफाइड. सो रोड साइड स्टैंड को एज अ पर्सन ट्रीट किया गया. रोड साइड स्टैंड पैथेटिकली प्लेड, सो रोड साइड स्टैंड इज पर्सोनिफाइड. एंड नेक्स्ट वन द सैडनेस इज ऑल्सो पर्सोनिफाइड. ओके, सो दिस आर द एग्जाम्पल्स of the figure of speeches, literary devices or poetic devices, you can also say. So next we come to the keywords. So at last here we come to the keywords from the poem. So I will be reading out the keywords. You can also see the keywords in the video itself. So first one, old house. Okay, the keywords are always marked with a single quotation mark. I also told you earlier in classes also. Okay, in offline classes I also told you earlier. So first one is old house, second one traffic sped, third pathetically pled, fourth dole of bread, next one withering faint, polished traffic, artless paint, wild berries, wooden quartz, golden quash, silver warts, hurt to the scenery. Okay, these are the keywords. Next we come the next stanza, city money, moving pictures, party in power, pitiful kin. Kin means relatives. Okay, good doers, beast of prey, ancient way, hardly bear, childish longing in vain, squeal of brakes. Squeal means the sound. Okay, selfish cars, pull up grass, gallon of gas, scale of gain, lift of spirit, great relief, stroke out, and the last one is the pain. Okay, this all are the examples of the keywords present in the poem, which I took out from the poem. Okay, so what is the significance or what is the importance of the keywords? I already told you earlier, but again I am repeating. So this keywords you can use in your answers. First thing, you can use these keywords in your answers. You can write down these keywords in your answers to fetch good marks, first thing. But the main reason of providing you the keywords is for, as I told you earlier also, recognizing the poem text when you will answer the reference to context in your exam. So these small words or these single words or these phrases will be helping you to recognize the text of the poem in your exam, so that you can recognize the poem when the reference to context appear in front of you in your exam, and you can give the answers, write down the answers well. Recognize the poem text when you will be attempting the reference to context in your exam. And one more use of these keywords are to answer the meanings if it appears in your exams, which I will provide you later on in the offline classes. Means what? कभी कभी क्या होता है कि reference to context में कुछ कुछ phrase का, some phrases का meaning रहता है कि what is the meaning of, for example, I'm giving you just a simple example. What do you mean by the childish longing in vain? Okay, what is the mean of squeal of brakes? Okay, but this kind of question can come. What is the meaning of pitiful kin? Okay, so ये क्या है, keywords की तरह act कर रहा है, तो इसका आप लोगों को meanings बताना है exam में. तो I'll be giving you the meanings in the offline classes after the college reopens. Okay, because you have to write it down itself in your in class. So by this we come to the end of the chapter Roadside Stand by Robert Frost. And I hope you all understood this poem also. The poem is a bit complicated, I must say. But if there is any kind of doubts you are having, just go through the video again and again. I just only repeat this line in my every lecture, I think. Okay, it's very weird to repeat it again and again. But for your benefit, I am saying, as we don't have any other option to conduct classes, offline class, you also know it very well. There is only one option, that is the online videos. Okay, though virtual classes, it's not enough for literature. Okay, literature ke liye virtual class bahut zyada enough nahi hota, online classes enough nahi hota, because literature means you have to understand it very well, you have to write down the notes. Okay, you have to understand the meanings. So jitna main se ho pa raha hai, I'm trying my level best to make you understand each and everything, the summary, the introduction, the explanation, the critical appreciation. But I am giving you only the explanation, a deep explanation, I must say. But the things will be get cleared more to you when I will be providing you the notes of the particular two poems I had done, that is A Thing of Beauty and Roadside Stand, and whatever I am going to do in coming future. Okay, so until and unless I provide you the notes of this chapter, obviously the explanation is incomplete, bit incomplete. Okay, but giving you online notes, okay, somebody told, few students have referred, told me, ma'am, why are you not giving the online notes, okay, in the video itself. See, I can give it to you all, but there is a disadvantage of it, because when I will be giving you the notes in offline class, okay, after the college reopen, there will be many things which we will come across what I have to make you understand again. Okay, for example, when I will dictate you the answers, when I will dictate you the question, important question, okay, there will be many things I have to make you understand again. Okay, the meaning of the particular answers, the meaning of the particular question, what does it mean? Because ek cheez hamesha ke liye, fir se I am repeating you again, hamesha ke liye bhul jaiye, jo cheez 11 mein kar chuke hain aap log, wo 12 mein repeat nahi hoga. The questions will not be so straight. The examiners or the board will not ask you the question so straight. The question will be bit twisted. So the twist rahega question mein. You have to understand it very well and you have to give the answers. Okay. So for only that reason, I can provide you the online question answers. Okay. It's not a big task for me. But I'm not giving you the online notes, the online question answer for your benefit, so that the students who will be present in my class, obviously I won't be giving the notes to each and every student. Those who will be present in my class, they will only get the notes or the question answers for the board's exam and for the detailed critical appreciation along with the summary and all things. Okay, interpretation, whatever I have to do, I had made out the notes for you all. But that only thing you have to, when I will dictate the answers to you, I will dictate the question to you, I will make you understand that questions, I will make you understand those particular answers, and again I will make you understand what you will write in your answers, what kind of material you will write in your answers. Because see, the thing is that to memorize completely is not possible. जो हम लिखाएंगे आप लोग को, जो हम आप लोग को नोट्स देंगे, पूरा नोट्स को मेमोराइज़ करना इट्स नॉट पॉसिबल, याद करना पॉसिबल नहीं है, किसी के लिए नहीं पॉसिबल होता. तो ऑब्वियसली यू विल बी पुटिंग सम अदर वर्ड्स बाई योर सेल्फ, ओके दैट्स वेरी ऑब्वियस. बट अपने से कुछ वर्ड्स पुट करने के लिए आंसर्स में आप लोग को टेक्स्ट समझना बहुत ज़रूरी है. और साथ ही साथ यू हैव टू ऑल्सो अंडरस्टैंड वॉट यू आर गोइंग टू राइट इन योर आंसर्स. ओके सो फॉर दैट रीज़न आई एम ऑप्टिंग फॉर द ऑफलाइन मोड टू गिव द क्वेश्चन आंसर्स, द गिव द नोट्स, बिकॉज देर विल बी अ लॉन्ग प्रोसेस. आई मस्ट से आप लोग ये मत सोचिएगा कि मैम है अचानक कॉलेज खुलेगा तो बस नोट्स दे देंगी. देर विल बी लॉन्ग प्रोसेस. एक चैप्टर का नोट्स एंड कम्प्लीट क्वेश्चन आंसर लिखने में इट विल टेक सम टाइम. और वही टाइम देंगे जिन लोगों को अच्छा मार्क्स लाना है. ओके इट विल ओनली बी योर, इट इज़ ओनली फॉर योर बेनिफिट. वैसे मेरा कुछ बेनिफिट नहीं होगा, उन लोग ही क्लास करेगा, उन लोग ही नोट्स टेक डाउन करेगा, उन लोग ही क्वेश्चन आंसर टेक डाउन करेगा जिनको ऑब्वियस है इंग्लिश में गुड मार्क्स लाना है. और एक चीज़ हमेशा जस्ट कीप दैट इन योर माइंड, टू रीड अ पर्टिकुलर पोर्शन ऑफ इंग्लिश. फॉर एग्जाम्पल इफ़ यू आर कॉन्सेंट्रेटिंग ऑन ओनली माई सिलेबस, फॉर एग्जाम्पल आई एम गिविंग यू एग्जाम्पल, इफ़ यू आर कॉन्सेंट्रेटिंग ओनली माई पार्ट, द पार्ट विच आई एम टीचिंग यू ऑन, या इफ़ यू आर कॉन्सेंट्रेटिंग ऑन सम अदर पार्ट ओनली, ओके या इफ़ यू आर कॉन्सेंट्रेटिंग ऑन सम अदर बुक, सो इट विल नॉट फेच यू अ गुड मार्क्स. ओके यू हैव टू टेक इट ऑल ओवर. आपको पूरा इंग्लिश को एक साथ सारा पार्ट्स को बहुत अच्छे से रीड आउट लर्न करना है, मेमोराइज करना है, जितना हो सकता है आपसे एफर्ट्स करना है, चाहे वो विस्तार्स हो, चाहे वो फ्लैमिंगो का पोइट्री हो, प्रोज हो, राइटिंग स्किल हो, रीडिंग स्किल हो, एनीथिंग वॉट एवर, देयर इज ईच एंड एवरी थिंग प्रेजेंट इन योर सिलेबस, यू हैव टू फोकस इट. ओके एंड देन ओनली यू कैन गेट, यू कैन फेच गुड मार्क्स इन इंग्लिश. ओनली कॉन्सेंट्रेटिंग ऑन प्रोज और ओनली कॉन्सेंट्रेटिंग ऑफ पोएम, ओनली कॉन्सेंट्रेटिंग ऑन विस्तास या ओनली कॉन्सेंट्रेटिंग ऑन राइटिंग स्किल वोंट फेच यू अ गुड मार्क्स. रिमेंबर माई वर्ड्स. ओके आई एम रिपीटिंग इट अगेन. आपको इंग्लिश में अच्छा मार्क्स लाने के लिए यू, इफ़ यू आर willing to fetch good marks, you have to learn English, you have to memorize each and every thing, whatever is taught, whatever is being taught by the teachers, all the English teachers. Okay, you have to take English subject as a whole. You can't be very partial with vistas, you can't be very partial with flamingo poetry or prose or writing skill. Okay, आप लोगों को सब एक साथ लेके आप लोग इंग्लिश पढ़ाई करना है, सो दैट आप लोगों को अच्छा मार्क्स आ सके. और कीप दैट इन योर माइंड, आई हैव टोल्ड यू अर्लियर ऑल्सो इन द ऑफलाइन क्लास. ओके लेट मी जस्ट रिपीट इन वंस इन ऑनलाइन क्लास. आप लोग का जो इंग्लिश का में जितना मार्क्स आएगा, वॉट एवर मार्क्स यू विल फेच इन योर इंग्लिश, ओके इन आई एम टॉकिंग अबाउट द बोर्ड्स, it will determine your percentage. If you are in science stream, if you are in arts stream, or if you are in commerce stream, it will determine your percentage of your stream. Okay, english ka marks niche hoga to aapko automatically percentage aapka streams ka kam ho jayega. Bolne ka zarurat nahi hai of online class mein ye cheez, but then also make एक बार हम आपको याद दिला दिए. ईच एंड एवरी स्टूडेंट्स आउट देयर हु आर वॉचिंग माई वीडियोज़, वॉचिंग माई लेक्चर्स एंड दोज हु आर फोकसिंग ऑन माई लेक्चर्स, फॉर देयर बेनिफिट आई एम टेलिंग. ओके सो इन माई नेक्स्ट लेक्चर आई एम गोइंग टू स्टार्ट अ न्यू पोएम, कीपिंग क्वाइट. ओके सो मीन वाइल यू ऑल गो थ्रू दिस एक्सप्लेनेशन ऑफ द पोएम गिवन टिल नाउ. All of and just read well, okay, and learn well, okay. All of you, take care and bye bye.